works. First of all, we will show how to make pellet of the sample. So first, this is the weighing balance. We take benzoic acid. We have already taken this benzoic acid, already weighted. Now I'll put it in the weight box, close it. This I want to show, the weight is 1.060. So what I am showing here is always take this measured value of benzoic acid. Now take this value for making pellet. The weight is 1060. Now for pellet, this is pellet press cup, pour all the sample. Now we know one thing, that the pellet cannot be more than 1.060 grams because this is the total weight. Now how this pellet press is used, I will show. Yeah, this is screw type pellet press. We'll just keep it tight. The sample get compressed. Now we'll open. Now sample get compressed. We will open it. Now to take out the pellet out of this pellet press cup. Now slowly rotate the handle. Take this pellet, the small paper. Now see, this is the pellet. Now we again weight this pellet. Now again we will put it inside this. Replace the. Now this is the final value. You see, we have taken 1.060. Now it is 1.050. So this way, to weight a powder sample is very easy. Suppose we take unmeasured value of this benzoic acid and then make the pellet, and if it is more, then we have to scratch it off, or if it is less, then again we have to do it. So this way our time is saved. So now the weight of that pellet is 1.050. This is how pellet is made. We are showing this for benzoic acid, and the same procedure is followed for the samples also. Now second part is how to how to tie ignition wire and cotton thread. I mean, how to put this sample in the bomb. This is our SS bomb. This is crucible ring having crucible. This way you can put on the bomb closer ring so that your both hands are free. Now take a small piece of ignition wire. We have to take 6 cm every time. Now that we have quite a practice, we do it every day, so we know by estimation. There is a groove on the electrode. You insert the wire on that groove and then push along that electrode, these small bushes. So this way, this ignition wire is tied. Now you can see, if you touch this wire, it is not loose. It should not be loose actually. So this way we have tied this ignition wire, and now we are taking this cotton thread. We have to take approximately 10 cm. So as we know by estimation, so take this cotton thread. It is of pure cotton, having non-calorific value. This way you tie in the center, just like this way. Now it knot is tied in the center. You twist from the bottom. So this way. This is cotton thread. Now crucible. Now take that. We have to take that benzoic acid tablet. We have to keep it in the crucible. Now always keep it like this, I mean cylindrical upward position. This is crucible ring. we have inserted this crucible. And one thing, see this, we touch this thread with this tablet. One precaution we have to do here is that there should be a gap. इसको थोड़ा नीचे कर दो. This is a smaller electrode. This is larger electrode. This crucible should not touch with this electrode. This precaution we have to take. See, there is a gap. Now we will keep the lid inside bomb. Tight the closure ring. Now we have to fill oxygen in this bomb. So far we have weighted the sample, kept inside the crucible, tied the ignition wire, tied the cotton thread. Now we have to fill oxygen in this bomb. For oxygen filling in this our model RSB7, we are having this is the oxygen cylinder that we do not supply. This is a pressure regulator that we supply along with this instrument. And to describe this pressure regulator, it is having two gauges. One gauge shows the pressure of the oxygen cylinder. Right now it is somewhere 110 kg. Mind it, we have to use only kg units. It is 100 plus kg units. So this shows the inside pressure of this oxygen cylinder. The second gauge shows the pressure that we have to work out, that we have to use. So we can set this temperature. Right now it is zero. First we have to set, we have to open this oxygen cylinder. When we open it, this is a T handle. As we turn it clockwise, you can see we have to set it to 35 to 40, somewhere 35 to 40. This 35 to 40 is also the kg unit. So after setting this, there are this two flexible tubes. One flexible tube is this. This flexible tube is at the back side of this digital unit, oxygen in, and there is a another port, oxygen out. So from pressure regulator, one tube goes to the oxygen in, and second port of this auto gas unit, oxygen out, and it goes to the bomb. Now first we have to keep this, it is called wall body O-ring. There is a groove, we have to fix this ring. Now we will tight this flexible tube cap with hand. One thing we have to notice that we have to tight all the connection 1 and out auto gas unit output port, input port, and here, all these are to be tight with bare hand only. No wrench or plus is required. Now that it is tied, now we will switch on this unit, turn this auto gas unit, and now we will push. As we push it, now you see that it has start rising. This 100 is in pounds and this 10 is kg per centimeter square. Now it is 10 kg per centimeter square. It is 12, it is 14. Like this, it will keep on increasing. We have to just keep this button pressed, and after reaching at around 28, this is 26. Yeah, now you can see that red light on. If you keep it pressed, nothing is happening. It has cut off the supply to the bomb. So this is whatever quantity is required by bomb, it will supply that quantity, and after that it will stop. This red light indicates that sufficient oxygen has filled inside the bomb. Now, to take out this bomb, what we have to do is, first we have to release the pressure from outside port. Slightly unscrew only one or two thread. You have noticed this sound. So whatever pressure is there inside this tube is released. Now again we have to tight this so that next time when we fill, if we do not tie it, then oxygen will get leaked from this point. Now you will see that this pressure gauge had become at zero. Now you can easily open it with hand here. If you will not release this pressure in this tube, then it is very difficult to open it. So now in this bomb, oxygen is filled, sample is there, ignition wire and everything is there. This is our outer jacket in which we have shown two or three things we have to take care. Some stickers are there. The main thing is this bomb support, and there is a welding strip. This is a welding strip. So this bomb support leg should be outside this welding strip. Now we will put this bomb. We will hold it with the like this, holding bomb holding hook. Now our bomb is capped inside this. Now we will fill water. We have to fill water around this bomb till it touches the surface of the bomb. We will fill slowly, slowly. Approximately 1900 ml to 2000 ml. Approximately 2 liter water is used. We have to use distilled water only. And one more thing regarding this water is, it should be distilled water. It should be changed. It has to be changed every time for testing. And the quantity of this water to be taken should remain constant for every test. For every single test, the quantity of this water should remain same. Now you will see this water level should be that it should touch this serial number marked on the bomb. So this is the local reference. The best way is, after testing, you measure this water, and suppose if it is 1800 or 1850 or whatever, you make a note of it and use always that ml of water every time. So now that we have put the water inside, water outside this bomb, now we will keep this electrical lead. We will insert this electrical lead, red or black, on any terminal, then keep a combined lid. There is a slot in the combined lid for this electrical lid, this bigger slot this way, and this notch back side, remove this thing. So now we will bring electronic unit. Now that bomb is kept inside, water is there. Now this is a digital unit. Now we connect the stirrer. We put the sensor inside this water. There is a port for sensor this way. Now we insert stirrer, for which we have informed in description part. This way. Now we will switch on digital unit. As we switch on, you will see the beep. After hearing the beep, the main homepage shows the company name and the temperature. And this is the printer button. When we switch it on, you will see a light will come up here. So now we will start the stirrer. For that, there is a switch at the back side. We have to connect the stirrer supply is given in this unit only, so that you need only one wall socket. Switch it on. Now you will be hearing a very light sound. So what we have to do is, after keeping sample inside, keeping stirrer inside and sensor inside, we have to wait for at least 5 minutes. See, here one thing I would tell about this stirrer, that pull ke dikhana, so this knob is there. It is given deliberately, as there is very less sound. So a window is given so that you can see that something is moving. This is a stirrer belt actually. So this knob is there. It is given deliberately, so you can open it by hand, and you can see this is motor pulley and this is propeller pulley, and it is driven with the help of stirrer belt. So after some time, if this get broken, then you can replace this stirrer belt by opening this stirrer unit lid. So now you have seen that this backlit is off. So once you press this back button, this backlit will become on. Now the temperature is 18.551. So this is the temperature. The resolution of this digital unit is up to third decimal place after decimal point. So at this point of time, we have to wait for 5 minutes, minimum 5 to 6 minutes, because sensor was outside in air, and when we kept it inside the water and this stirrer is on, so the temperature inside will become homogeneous. So it will take approximately 5 to 6 minutes. If I show you about the settings, if I press the menu button, this is the option page. There are 4 options: water equivalent, CVT plus CVW, processing time, memory. If I keep it pressed, then these will rotate in cyclic form. So basically there are 4 options. First option is water equivalent, and you can see there is an arrow. It shows that this option is selected. Suppose I want to work on CVT plus CVW, then I have to bring this option to the first line by pressing up button. So when I press up button, now this is there. CVT is calorific value of thread, CVW is calorific value of wire. So suppose I want to see what is there inside this, I want to go inside this option, then to go inside I have to press menu button. When I press menu button, it is showing CVT plus CVW 30.32. Always remember that this value should remain same for every test. So to move further, I have to press menu button, menu, once again menu to come out. Now I will show third option, processing time. To go inside, first I will bring this to the first line, processing time. Then I will press menu button. Now the result time is 15. It is important, don't change it. It should always remain 15 minutes. To go out, press menu button. Now the third option is water equivalent. To go inside, press. Now it is 2350. It is factory setting. If you want to change, the cursor is blinking on first digit. Suppose you want to change first digit, press up, it will increase. You press down, it will decrease. To move next digit, press menu button. Suppose it is same, press again menu button. Suppose by chance you notice that on the first digit the value should be 3. So you can press back button. By pressing back button, the cursor will again become to the first digit so that you can change it. So at present we are keeping it 2350, and after fourth place, again if I press menu button, it will come out. And fourth option is memory. In memory we cannot edit anything. There are 11 memory location. If I press up button, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, and after 11 again it will come 1. So it will rotate in cyclic form if I pressing up button. So the last result, it is stored in the last memory location. Now to go back, I will press back button. This to come out of this menu option, again I have to press back button. This is the home page. So now that some time has elapsed, so what I am doing is I am firing the sample. To fire the sample, we have to keep this electrical lead already at the back side. Now this lead, one end is connected here at the back side of unit and one end on the top of the bomb on the terminals. Now I will press fire button. Now it is showing enter mass. Enter, our mass is 1 point, okay. Press, yeah, menu button, it was 0, yeah, 5. Make it 5, no. See, we have to press 1.050. So I will again press back button. This is 1 is okay, to go ahead, press menu. This 0 is okay, go ahead, to go ahead, press menu. Now we have to change it to 5, so it is 3. We have to push up button 2 times. Now it is 5. To go ahead, next digit, press menu. We have to make it 0. So press 2 times down button. So this was the mass we entered. Now after doing this, press menu button. Now it is 4, 5, 3, 1 counting down. This red light is glow. Now it is showing it was the temperature at which it was fired. Sample was fired. Temperature rise, it automatically do. Zero setting, and you can see this printer paper will record the temperature reading after every 10 seconds. It will come up like this. So now you have seen this temperature has started rising. At this point of time, we do not have any control in the instrument. Once we fire the sample, instrument take over all the controls. If we press any switch, it won't work. After a preset of 15 minutes, it will closely monitor the temperature for 15 minutes, and whatever is the maximum temperature within that period, it will take that reading and calculate and give the results. In this printer you can see after every 10 seconds it is typing temperature rise like this. Now you can see that the temperature rise so far has risen to 2.592. Within this 50 minute it may rise to the higher value and then it may come down also. In that case, like in this case, you can see the temperature rise, it has risen to 2.601 to 2.604, 2.601, 604, 605, 601, 602, 602, and now it is down 585. So it will use the maximum temperature rise for the calculation part. See, this beep is there. Now it has shown temperature rise is 2.608 and GCV value is 5808. And here all the calculation part is there. Like water equivalent is this, it was set earlier. Temperature rise is this. It has taken the highest value 2.608. Then CVT plus CVW 30.32, mass of sample 1.050, and then GCV is this. Now for benzoic acid case, our main objective is to find out the water equivalent. So to find out the water equivalent, we have to press the fire button again. When I'll press the fire button again, at this point, see, it is asking the calorific value. Now it is asking the calorific value, what calorific value of benzoic acid that we have used. In every benzoic acid box, we paste the value of this. The benzoic acid calorific value is 6319. So we have to feed this value, not the value that just given by the machine. So we will feed 6319 when it is already there. So I'll move further, and again when I'll press menu button, it will show the water equivalent. This water equivalent is 2555, and you can see report is also there. Temperature I, CVD, W, CVW, mass of sample, non-calorific value 6319, and water equivalent is 2555. So this way, we have to find water equivalent for three samples, and then take the average of that sample, and then we have to feed in the water equivalent. Now our this test is over. So first of all, we'll switch off the stirrer. We will switch off the stirrer, then we'll take out the sensor first. Then we will take out the stirrer unit. Keep it backside. Open the combined lid, remove the lid, take out bomb with bomb lifting hook, keep it here. Now to open the bomb, we'll press this. It will not open. First we have to release the oxygen. One gas leasing pin is there in the accessory box. Only after release of oxygen, then only this bomb can open. Otherwise, it won't open. Now open. Take the lid up, and now see the crucible. Now you can see there is no sample left. Absolutely nothing. 100% complete combustion. So this is what it is desired. In case of coal samples or other sample, some unburned material left. So we have to take notice of that thing also. We have to measure that thing also. So this is how this complete work experiment is done. Now one thing I will show that the last calorific value was 5808. So now if I go to the first, I will press the back button, menu button. Now I will go to the memory option, up memory option, then press menu button. So the last result is third in memory equivalent. Third value is 5808. If I see memory, if I press the up button, it will show the memory location 4. So it is empty now. So whatever last result we do, if I do next result, then its value will come to the fourth value, like that. So this is all about model RSB7. In case of model RSB6, we do not have this printer. the unit in, no sorry, we have this printer, but the auto, instead of auto gas unit, we have this type of gas filling arrangement. We have this oxygen, then we have oxygen control valve, then we have the flexible tube. This flexible tube goes to the safety device, and then after safety device it will go to the pressure gauge, and after this pressure gauge this will go to the like this. We have to tie it. So in case of our other models, oxygen filling system is like this: oxygen control valve, flexible tube, safety device, pressure gauge, and then two bomb. As we open this oxygen control valve knob, this oxygen is start coming from this point to bomb through the safety device and pressure gauge. And when this pressure gauge shows 26 kg, then we will stop by rotating this knob. So this is in our other models. So this is all about working operation of digital bomb calorimeter. Thank you.